Let me show you guys my MIPS computer after I posted a screenshot of it on Reddit, like the first running version. I improved it a bit. This part is new, which is load and store. Some matching happening there, and we got this massive screen. It's 40 characters by 4 line. And it's basically a shift register, and if you get a new line, it will shift upwards. So it will write from, basically the characters will appear down here and then be shifted upwards or to the left. We have a keyboard. This is not, I'm not gonna show this today because my program doesn't do that. Those devices are, this is a MIPS computer, and I use the MMIO kind of stuff. There's an like a transmit receive memory map device which is used by Mars and SPIM, the those MIPS simulators, and they basically behave like that, so you can write to exactly those addresses. I believe the keyboard is like FFFF0000 for the control register probably, and then the next word is for the character, I think, or the other way around. Behaves exactly like that, same for the screen. I added another peripheral here, which is a disk. This is the disk mod. Link in the description or Google it. First of all, I'm gonna load the program. So my, this is not the program, my MIPS program is basically, well, this initializes the stack, and then we set the frame. MMI does disk sit frame. Set frame will tell the disk reader to switch to frame 10. We'll see in a second why it's frame 10. And then we will load this address, which is where the disk frame is mapped to. And then we just go through a loop where we read the byte from this memory mapped disk frame and display it on the on our screen, and just go through until we read a 0 byte. This is, by the way, those are macros, so I have the MMIO definitions here, so it's basically receiver and transmit, control and data registers. I have a clock register and buzzer register, which I don't use yet. This will basically be a simple clock that counts ticks from an average, basically from when you reset the machine, and a buzzer. Then we have the disk stuff. Network will be for my rail network. That's not done yet. I'm working on it. I need a script to generate that. And we have disk control and data. Control basically sets the disk frame, and then you can starting from this address, can read 256 words. So basically a frame is every signal that factory has. There are 257 in vanilla. So I just said, okay, let's use 256 signals, but we map them to an address so we can read them. So basically a frame are 256 bytes, and one disk can store 512 frames, so we can store quite a lot of data. So what I will do then usually is, first of all, I need to compile a program. That script will do that. It uses Mars to basically assemble the stuff to a binary blob, and then generates a blueprint. I will change this to generate an actually usable blueprint. This is kind of usable. What I do is I paste it here. This is the whole program. I will copy it onto this constant combinator, and this is kind of a bootloader. It will copy the data from here into the memory over here. So, is the machine reset? Yeah, so have to be kind of careful. It's not very, it's just a prototype still. So let's load that. While that is loading, I can generate a disk. And I created a simple file format that can store multiple files and has an index, and will store that on a disk. As you can see, let me probably stop that here. So I also stored a program on there. It will store files in blocks of 4 kilobytes. That's 4 frames, so 2 to 5, like 0 frame doesn't exist. Frame 1 is the index, and then frame 2 to 5 is my first file, 6 to 9 is my second file, and I have this hello world dot which I actually want to change. So we have a couple less characters. Really? Oh. Yeah, escape it, write it. And now I can just generate a disk with those files in a simple file system format. Copy that. Let's switch to Factorio. I'm gonna close IntelliJ and Mars though, because that will help with the frame rate. So, this is the disk. Gonna insert that here. And it's already set to 10 because I tested it before, but the program will also set this frame number. It's basically when you receive a write on a specific address, it will write this into this register, which will select a frame. And then if you read from the memory mapped area, which is decided by a few combinators, calculated address, and then using this index, it will read from the frame. This is the frame, so it will select the specific signal that we need at this address and put it onto the read data bus. Okay, so we are at the first instruction. I'm gonna step through a couple of instructions, I guess. 15 is load upper immediate because that's the initialization of the stack. It's this, yeah. And then we load the other half. 9 is actually already, that's an at immediate unsigned, and another 41 is a store half. This sets the frame. And now we have opcode 9, which is another addition. 32 is the load byte. So this will load the first byte. And then it would just loop through, it will load that byte and then write it to the address of the screen and thus print it. I will just run it. Currently it runs at, it takes 22 ticks per instruction. It's not optimized at all. Like, I just tried around with the clock speed that we could get, and this worked. So you might have seen the text. So it started writing the bytes to the screen. You can maybe, so first of all, this instruction decoding, this is the next PC environment with the branch condition evaluation unit. This is the ALU, it's not complete yet. We, for example, don't have multiply and divide and stuff like that. This is the store logic. The memory operates on 32-bit words, so we have to extract the correct bit all the time. And this is the write logic, where basically when you write to a word, you first have to read the word and then mask certain bits and then combine them. Oh, also this does assign extension if you load bytes assigned. Yeah. So this thing here is the register bus. The registers file is just a memory that's 32 words and is only word addressable. But works principally the same as the other memory. This is the memory bus. It goes down here to everything here is a page. this is mapped to 400,000, this is to map to this address. That's the addresses that Mars use for a normal program, and we have a stack. I think we're probably done. So it's... No, it's not done yet. Should be done soon, though. Oh, there was a new line at the end. Didn't know that. Now it's in the endless loop, I believe, yeah. Yeah, so it copied the from a disk, from a file, practically, from a disk onto the screen. That's what that program does. Just to show you the dimensions. So this is the screen. Some debug stuff. This is just where I tried around. This is the CPU, basically. All this stuff here. Disk drive. Registers, and then the memory, and the memory is really not very small. So every column, like this column here, and this column each is 4 kilobytes. So it's exactly a page, and that's why it's that big. Most of the time I didn't use all the memory yet, so yeah. That's my MIPS computer in Factorio. Thank you for watching. I'll probably post an update once I get all the stuff working. Bye!